Welcome to this Windows and Computer channel, and this is a quick update to an answer answering questions from users about the new browser, the new Microsoft Edge Chromium browser that you can actually download. So this is what it looks like right now, and so a few questions came to mind from some of the readers and the people. So basically, it works well. First of all, I gotta say I've been using it as my main browser for the past 24 hours, just to see how it goes. It actually seems to work really well. It actually seems to be fast. I've had no problems with it. Didn't crash anything. It is a very nice implementation of the browser. Of course, it's Chromium, so the basics are the motor behind Google Chrome. Chromium is an open source. A lot of people saying, well, you know, they're using Chrome. They're using Chromium. It's an open source project. It's not Google Chrome. It's Chromium. It's a different thing. It's really an open source project. And they decided to base their Edge browser. They put their top layer of Edge on it. So it does have the feel of Microsoft Edge, which is nice. And of course, as we will continue, we will eventually have all the implementations of Edge, because Microsoft Edge has a lot of different little things you can do, including, you see here on the upper right, you can annotate, you can write on the page if you want. These are features that are apparently used by some people, quite a lot of people that actually enjoy having this and being able to annotate. But right now, what we have is mostly the first implementation. All of the features will eventually be there. One of the questions that comes to mind that people ask, does it sync everything from Edge? It doesn't sync everything. It just syncs the favorites right now, or the bookmarks. That, you know, will be synced. It's the only thing that syncs right now. Eventually, all of the stuff will sync, of course. Does it take less resource than Google Chrome? Is it faster than Chrome? Look, it's the same basics and the you know, behind the scenes, if you want. Look, I've got Chrome and I've got Microsoft Edge Chromium open with the same page. If you look here, there, you know, Chrome has six different processes running with 132 megabytes, and you've got Edge running with four processes with 110 megabytes. It's not enough to really say, well, there's a big difference, especially because I've been using both browsers, so there could be, you know, something that has bloated or something. I don't know. Is it better or not? Only time will tell. And it's, like I said, it's very difficult because you want me to talk about something that at the behind the scenes is the same, you know, Chromium project. So it's really kind of not comparable that much because they're very, very much alike except for the top layer of Edge over it. Also, some people have been asking, is it faster than Edge or is it better than Edge? Look, it looks fast. For me, I can't say it's faster or slower. It seems to be as fast. And that's pretty much what I have to say. The one thing that is faster, and it's probably because it's part of the system once it's installed, the first time that you click on the Edge Chromium icon and load Edge, it actually loads faster than the first run of Chrome. But once you've run Chrome once, there's still a part of it that's lying in RAM memory, so it actually becomes as fast after that. So, you know, it's difficult to compare, really, but and I would say it's as fast as Microsoft Edge. Some people that were having problems with some websites, and I know a few people that have been telling me that there are some websites they went to that have problems with Edge, and I know that Edge isn't perfect on some websites. Although it worked pretty much everywhere that I go, it still has these little something left on some of the websites, including one of the websites that I can talk about is YouTube. When you go to the YouTube creators page, Google Chrome, you are instant, almost, it's almost instant. you're there. In Edge, it takes a long time before Edge actually loads it up. Now, in Edge Chromium, it also is as fast as Google Chrome, probably because of the Chromium background to it. It gets fooled a little bit on some websites, websites that are trying to find out if you're using Edge or not, or kind of not really knowing what browser you're actually using. So it's kind of weird on that. For the rest, it still has a lot of things that's missing that are going to be added with time. Like I said, it only syncs the favorites, nothing else. So that's one thing. Also, just, you know, remember that there's a lot of things missing. They kind of implement the Edge or the Microsoft version of it. So, of course, the start page is the start page for Bing. Of course, you can change it, but I mean, the start page is really for Bing. So if I started, this is what you look. It looks like at the startup, which is the Bing page where you actually have all of your favorite websites that you actually can go to. They are showing up here, which is nice. Like you see, it's pretty fast. It doesn't have all the Google services implemented in it. So Google Chrome does, but it's, of course, Google Chrome. It's Google's own browser. Here it's Microsoft's browser, so they have kind of stripped out a lot of the Google services that were within the browser. Of course, that could technically make it a little faster, but we'll see with time. My first impressions are really good. It works well. What I can't wait to see is when they'll implement the dark theme. It doesn't seem like the dark theme is there yet. And the settings. But and of course, the settings are kind of going on the page a little bit like, you know, Google Chrome. Settings are different, are more Chrome-like rather than Edge-like. And one last thing, a lot of you have been asking me, appearance, let's just go see if appearance has dark theme here. Always fonts, customized fonts. Yeah, it doesn't have much choice here, and it doesn't have any, doesn't have the customizing of getting the dark theme yet, which is probably going to arrive at some point. So anyways, one of the things that a lot of people have been asking, do I go to the feedback hub to give feedback on problems I have with Edge Chromium? No, on the upper right corner you have a little smiley face. Click on that and it will bring up the send the feedback stuff. You can describe what's happening. If it's related to a website, make sure that you're on that website where it's happening so that the URL matches the website. Include your email and send system information if you want to have some telemetry sent out. And you can include screenshot if you want. By including the screenshot, you will actually have a visual of maybe what you're trying to explain, which is not always easy. But that's where you'll send the feedback, on the upper right corner. So my first impressions are really good. It's fast, works well, and can't wait to when it will officially be, you know, done. And I think this is going to be the browser I'm going to use as my main browser when it's done. I already am thinking of using it quite regularly right now. If you enjoy my videos, please subscribe, give us a thumbs up. Thank you for watching.